Welcome to Scene in New York. I'm Paisley Chang. Today we're coming to you from Velour Lounge in New York City's Chelsea neighborhood. And now we're joined by Anthony Piazza, the owner of Velour Lounge. Hi.
Hi, Paisley. How are you today?
Good. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for coming over.
So what are some of the special things about this lounge that we can expect?
Oh, Velour is a place with no hassles. It's a nice, warm environment. People come in, they enjoy the music, they enjoy the scene. We have great art that's up on our walls. Once a month we do live paintings. We have the most fantastic drinks that are prepared with fresh organic ingredients. And we also serve food until 4 a.m., which not very many of our competitors do.
Yeah, how can you beat that, right?
Exactly.
Well, listen, we've got a great show for you. We're going to sample some of Velour's offerings, but we're also going to tell you about a history of the Bushwick neighborhood. We're going to tell you about some desserts that are so good you're going to want to wear them. And we're also going to tell you about some toys, some old school toys that are making a big comeback. Scene in New York starts now. So Anthony, you were telling me that once a month you have a live artist working here?
Yeah, once a month one of our artists will come in and he'll do a live painting and allow members of the audience and our guests to actually interact and paint on the canvas.
Is that what's going on here?
Yeah, it's actually going on right behind you now.
So the artist paints his work. And then people who come here are allowed to come over here and just add their own little touch to it.
That's correct. And actually, it starts with a blank canvas, though. It's not done in advance. It's a blank canvas, and by the time it's done, it usually turns into something very interesting and new. And
Well, that's sort of cool, because then people who come here to, you know, party can also contribute to the artwork that's on the wall.
That's correct. And if you look on our website, we have it noted. We do it once a month here.
Okay. The Dumbo neighborhood of Brooklyn is known for its loft-like apartments with slamming New York City views, but it's also known for its art scene.
Right.
The common assumption is that reading is something you do on your own, but some very creative folks in the city are making reading a community activity. It's a neighborhood that survived economic busts and riots. We're talking about Bushwick, Brooklyn, and according to Gabe Pressman, it's experiencing a revival.
It was only...
Coming up after the break, a museum for heroes will explain when Scene in New York returns. Welcome back to Scene in New York. Once again, we're coming to you from Velour Lounge. Now, Anthony, this is some of the food that you can get here?
Yeah, at Velour, we like to serve until 4 a.m., so we have a short menu, but it has some very delicious things, and we try to do whatever we do, but very well.
Okay, so what are we looking at here?
We don't have a fryer here at Velour, so none of this food is fried. These are mozzarella sticks. We have pepperoni pizza. This is chicken egg rolls. By the way, I was in the kitchen throwing up the pizza just before you got here.
Okay.
This is a salameria plate made with boar's head cold cuts. And we have a cheese plate. We serve it till 4 a.m. It's served fresh. It's made to order. And can't get better than that. And everything is $12 and under.
Okay. So, Anthony, are you a comic book and a cartoon fan?
Now and then.
Okay. Well, you're in luck because there's a museum downtown that's devoted to it. Our friends are NYC TV. Tell us. Well, talking comic books might make you think about the toys you had from yesteryear. We're talking about Etch-n-Sketches. I think you know what I'm talking about. Our friends at Thrillist tell us about some stuff we had when we were kids. Coming up after the break, we've got tips for you when it comes to navigating the subway. Hit it. Welcome back to Scene in New York. Well, one of the greatest things about the New York City subway is that for one fare, you can transfer from one line to the next, but that's not always the case, as Andrew Siff explains in Y Train. After the break, we'll tell you about some spa treatments that are so delectable, you're gonna wanna eat them when Scene in New York returns. Welcome back. So, Anthony, this is what you're calling edible paints?
Yeah, that's correct. It's actually liqueurs, okay. And we use food coloring on them, uh-huh. And you could paint with them, and the colors match the flavor. So, for instance, the yellow is banana, the orange is passion fruit, the green is melon, and they're very delicious. And when the painter comes in and does the live paintings, people like to paint along with them, and it's pretty interesting.
So it's not paint by number, but paint by flavor?
Yeah, pretty much so. And you can drink them, too.
And these paints aren't the only thing that tastes delicious. Erica Tarantell shows us some spa treatments that are good enough to eat. Well, that's all the time we have now. Once again, we're coming to you from Velour Lounge. It's on 10th Avenue and 27th Street. That'll do it for Scene in New York. I'm Paisley Chang. See you next time. I like this red color.
Can't have the...